An example from the city of Rotterdam. This too is about resilience. You can see, this is the high sidewalk, and when it hasn't rained so hard and there isn't so much water, here along the benches, there's another of these sidewalks. But it's a resilient place. It's a place in the city that can change character. Sometimes it's dry, and sometimes it's wet. And this takes also a change of mentality for us. We're not used to places changing character in the meantime. They're either one way or the other. And I think this bridge is a great symbol of how this place can change character. I asked the designer of Rotterdam, I said, uh-oh, I think something went wrong. And he said, no, on the contrary. We did this purposely. The city of Rotterdam purposely designed this bridge to disappear into water, thinking that this will help people realize that yes, this place can change character. Sometimes it's wet, sometimes it's dry, and when the water recedes, no problem. I think it's since we're all trying to get people more aware of water issues and what this can mean for their own cities and their own lives, I thought this was such a simple thing, but still really significant. You see that more and more water is being brought into the built environment. On the right, this is the image that you saw on the poster. This is a housing development in Amsterdam. Where the houses go straight into the water, where people have their own little docks behind the houses and can have their own boats. And on the left, you see a planned development. This is a rendering of a new development also in Amsterdam, where you see that the housing and the water are even more closely connected. And I understood from Mr. Tan that in a project here in Singapore, Bishan Park, that the for sale private housing next to this park has now increased, since the park was realized, in value by 100%. The houses have become twice as valuable because they have green and water outside. So this is also a financial incentive to make our cities safer and more beautiful. This is an important project in the city of Rotterdam, which was realized just last December it opened. And these are called the water squares. This too, again, is about making the city resilient and flexible when sometimes there's water and sometimes there isn't. These basins here are actually, when they're not full of water, just places to sit, to chat. The students from the schools around them come out to play basketball, and people just hang around and sit in the sun. When it rains, these basins fill up, and of course nobody sits there. Then gradually the water seeps back down into the groundwater or into the sewer, and all you have to do again is clean up, and that's all there is to it. I think these are a very interesting project in Rotterdam because they show us much about what urban design can mean for us, but it's also an interesting question. What is climate change going to bring us in the increased amount of water? How many of these water squares will a city like Rotterdam need? And how much do they cost? So I think looking forward, Rotterdam will be looking at the question, is this a solution that brings us enough capacity for water storage? And do we have enough places in the city to build these? So the issue of urban design for water is really becoming the forefront, I think, of urban design in general.